guys, I'm Samina. Today on the Cupcake Confession, I'm showing you how to make Banoffee layer cake. Now this cake has several elements and they all pair so beautifully together. So we have the banana sponges, we have caramelized bananas, and we have the most amazing Swiss meringue buttercream that is flavored with Dulce De Leche. Now I decided to add this because it is extremely rich in terms of flavor. So you could use normal caramel sauce, but I came across, or I was introduced to Dulce De Leche some time back, and it is basically condensed milk that you keep cooking to the point where it gets nice and caramelly. So it adds this amazing depth of flavor to the entire cake that I think is just brilliant. I'm going to show you how to make this banoffee layer cake, and here's how you do it. So the very first thing that we're going to do is sift all our dry ingredients. So here I have my all-purpose flour and baking powder. Now if you are using unsalted butter, you should also add some salt in this mix. I love using salted, so I'm not adding the salt here. I'm then going to give it a good whisk, keep it aside. Then I'm going to move on to mashing up my bananas. So I have two bananas here that I'm going to roughly mash together. This will be used for the sponges. So once they're mashed, we're going to move on to making the sponges. At this stage, I would recommend preheating the oven to 160 degrees Celsius or 325 degrees Fahrenheit. Now we're going to start creaming our butter and sugars together. So I have my salted butter, brown sugar and caster sugar, and I'm going to keep mixing them until they go really nice and pale, fluffy and creamy. They should turn several shades lighter in their color. Halfway through the creaming process, I'm also going to take my spatula and I am going to scrape the sides, and I'm also going to go inside the bowl, not inside but you know, under as well, not just the sides. And then I'm going to add the eggs one at a time and mix really, really well between each addition. If you try to add all the eggs in one go, it's just going to be a curdled, soupy mess. And it's also not great when you're trying to incorporate air into your sponges. Once all the eggs are incorporated, mix it well for like 10 seconds, then add in your mashed bananas. Mix it again for another, say, 20 seconds or so until everything is really well combined. Then you're going to start adding the flour mixture that we had sifted a bit earlier or in the beginning of the video. You will add about a third of that flour, and then you're going to add your vanilla extract. Mix it really well. Now you're going to also add the milk, which is one of your liquid ingredient section. Then you're going to start adding the flour again. So you're going to alternate between the flour and the milk mix. And while you're doing that, you're also going to also make sure that you're scraping the sides and going under the batter as well to mix everything well and make sure everything is well incorporated. Whatever you do, always make sure that the last batch of ingredients that go in is your dry ingredients, because that helps bring the sponge or the batter together really, really beautifully. So once you have mixed everything well and scraped the sides of the bowl, give it a final mix for like 10 to 20 seconds. And you don't want to overwork the batter here, but you just want to make sure everything is well combined. Here I have 2 6-inch cake tins that I have greased generously and lined with parchment paper. In this, I'm trying to distribute the cake batter as evenly as possible. So I use my spatula and then I will even out the tops of the cakes, or the batter rather, to make sure that the bake on these cakes is even. And then I am going to make sure that I pop this into the oven at 160 degrees or 325 degrees Fahrenheit for about, I'd say, 35 to 40 minutes. A skewer inserted in the center must come out clean and they should feel springy to the touch. Let them cool completely in their tins. Then you're going to take your spatula, go around the sides of the cake after about half an hour when they're out of the oven, and then you're going to turn it onto a wire rack and let it cool completely. Now while that's happening, while your cakes are baking, after they're baked and cooling, we're going to move on to make our caramelized bananas. So we have here some butter, and to that I'm adding my bananas. I'm just going to roughly break it apart with my fingers, and then I'm going to add some sugar to it. And then comes the part where you just have to basically keep stirring this thing till it goes from this really solid solid mass of bananas and sugar and butter to a point where it goes really jammy. and it starts, the sugar starts to caramelize and break down the bananas as well, and that's what it would look like. It would start catching a bit at the bottom, and that's when you know it's done. You're gonna keep that aside, let it cool. Here now I have some Swiss meringue buttercream. The recipe is on my YouTube channel. I have linked it below. And to that I'm going to add the dulce de leche. Now it depends on how much you want to add. But what I like to do is make a batch and then take about 70% of that frosting out, so I can add some more dulce de leche to the rest of that Swiss meringue buttercream, because I'm trying to create an ombre effect. Now I try to avoid using food colors as much as possible, and I like to keep the colors as natural in the cake. So I like to add a bit more dulce de leche. Now that we have everything ready, we're going to start assembling the cake. First thing we're going to do is level our cake layers. So I'm going to take the tops off. And once I've done that, I'm also going to make sure that I slice this one layer into half, so I get four even layers. Now once I have all of the layers organized, I'm going to start assembling this cake. So on a cake stand, I like to add a little bit of the frosting so the layer sticks to the stand and doesn't shuffle around while you're decorating the cake. So here I have the Swiss meringue frosting that we had made using dulce de leche. So I'm going to add that, then I'm going to top it with some caramelized bananas, and then with some more dulce de leche. Finally, once the cake is assembled, I'm going to add the frosting at the top and along the sides. This is basically the crumb coat stage, where I'm trying to keep the crumbs securely attached to the cake so that when we do our final frosting, it's clean and it's really elegant looking. And then you're just going to take a damp cloth or a kitchen towel and go around the sides of the cake tin, the sides of the cake stand, and get all of the excess frosting out. You're going to smooth the tops of your cakes as well. You're going to freeze this for about 20 minutes, or you can even pop in the refrigerator for 4 to 5 hours till it's really chilled. Now we're going to do the ombre frosting. So the darker Swiss meringue buttercream frosting goes at the bottom. So you're going to do about 2 lines of those along the sides of the cake. Then you're going to put the lighter frosting on top of that, or in the other half, the top half of the cake, and you're also going to put that same frosting on the top of the cake. Now you're going to use your bent scraper or cake scraper, and very very smoothly, in an even motion, you're going to just scrape the sides, and that'll add this beautiful ombre effect to the cake. Make sure that your hands are really stable when you're doing that, and you're not going back and forth with the cake scraper, because that can mess the design. Look at the empty spots or any spots that need correction or need more cream, and then add a few blobs of the buttercream, and then smooth it out with your bent scraper. And then we're going to take the darker buttercream frosting, and we're just going to pipe some swirls here. So I have a star tip here that I'm going to use. You can avoid this or decorate it in any way you want, but I like doing this. And once I have all the swirls frosted, I'm going to top them with some chocolate nutties on top. This is just a candy we get in India that's really famous, and I love the caramelly crunch inside it. So this is the banoffee cake that is ready, and we are now going to slice into this so you can see all the delicious layers that lie within it. So here you can see 4 beautiful layers sandwiched with Swiss meringue buttercream frosting flavored with dulce de leche. There's also caramelized bananas and dulce de leche on its own. This is an absolutely beautiful cake, you guys. You have to make this. That's it, guys. That was my recipe for the banoffee layer cake. As you can see, it is really really easy. There are a few elements, but if you are well prepared, so say we can prepare the sponges beforehand and we can prepare the caramelized bananas beforehand, so they have enough time to really cool down, and the next day you can work on your Swiss meringue buttercream and then just assemble everything, and you have the perfect banoffee cake to serve your friends, family, loved ones. If you have any comments, feedback or suggestion, as always, pop them down in the comments below. And if you like this recipe, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. And also, I post every Tuesday and Thursday, so if you want to be notified, don't forget to press this bell button while you subscribe so that you're notified every time I post a new recipe. So that's it from me, guys. I'll be back again next time with amazing new recipes. So until I see you again, bye.